Good morning, students. Once again, welcome back to Web Technologies class. In the last class, already have explained presentational elements, means how to change the style of the document using a different elements. Okay, like bold, italic, subscript, superscript, like that. Today, here I am going to explain you about phrase elements. See, it is actually what is the use of the presentational element? It gives some styles to the document. Similarly, here the phrase elements which gives some information about a content. Okay, it will explain something about the content. Example, ABBR is a phrase element. ABBR is a phrase element. Actually, what it is? Abbreviation. Okay, so here we have some elements. That elements gives information about your content. So that elements will come under the phrase elements. That elements, today here I am going to explain you, means how to write, what are that elements and how to write that elements in a HTML document, that I will explain today. Here, we have some list of a phrase element which gives some information about your document. Okay, so the first one is an emphasize, strong, abbreviation, definition, black quotes, cite, code, address, cue, quotes, acronym. So these are the list of the phrase elements. You can take a screenshot of this and you have one lab program on this. Okay, now we discuss about each and every phrase element. First you take a screenshot of this. First, EM. EM stands for emphasis. Okay, so actually this is similar to italic style, but it forces to give some importance to that text. Okay, like this. EM, text, and emphasis. It is similar to italic only. But it is giving more attention on the text. Okay, that is the emphasis. The next one is a strong. Okay, so strong is also similar to bold, but it gives more emphasis on the text which you have included inside the strong. Again, you see that text strong. Similar to bold only. But more attention you will get on the text if you include that text between a strong opening and a closing. The next one is abbreviation. Okay, ABBR, abbreviation. Abbreviation. So ABBR that is used to give abbreviation to a word. Example, we have a WT. WT stands for a web technologies. So here we give the abbreviation ABBR. What is the title of that abbreviation? Title equals to web technologies. And it closes. And what is the abbreviated word? WTABBR. Okay, this is for the abbreviation. So, using ABBR tag, you can give abbreviation to a particular word. Okay, so here, this is a word, for this is a meaning. Okay, now similarly, definition, DFN. Again, this tag is also used to give some definition to the word. For any word, if you want to give the definition, then we use a DFN. Actually, the thing is, this tag is written inside the paragraph tag only, like this. Paragraph. Next, I am using DFN. Here, DFN stands for the definition. Next, computers. Example, or WT web technologies. And I want to give the definition of that. Like, this is a web technologies class. Example. Then, close the paragraph. So DFN is used to give the definition to the term. So this is a term to which we are giving a definition. Okay, so this is the definition. Okay, so here DFL stands for the definition. Okay, DFL stands for the definition, and this tag is enclosed between a paragraph opening and closing. And the next phrase element is block quote. Block quote means if you want to create any text in one block, in one section, if you want to create a text as a separate section, then we use a block quote like this. B-L-O-C-K, block quote. An example, I have 10 lines of text. I want to create that text as a particular section. Then you can use block quote. Okay, this is a block quote. Means using a block quote, you can create a section, one particular section in the document. Okay, this is a block. Next, here this CIT stands for a citation. Citation means this tag gives the title to the work. Whatever title, whatever work you have done, if you want to give a title, example, if you have done some research, if you want to give a title, that will be included between a citation. Okay, again give a text whatever you want to give and close the citation. Okay, that is the citation tab. And this tag is also included between a paragraph opening and the closing, example ABC. And close paragraph, example, if web technologies, the subject is teached by example some ABC, then you get like this, web by ABC. So if you want to give a title, in that case we use this citation tag. Okay, so example, network is the teach, the subject is teached by Usha, example, then paragraph CITT, example Usha Madam, close this one, and subject example networks. So how will you get when you execute this program, when you execute this line, how will you get networks by, like this way. Okay, so this is used to give a citation about the text. Okay, now what is the next one? Code. Actually, what is a code tag? In the name itself, we have a code. In the name itself, we have a meaning. Like if you want to create a code like A equals to C plus B, example, E equals to MC square. So if you want to create a such codes, that you can include inside of this code. See, example, how to include this? Example, I want to write E equals to MC square, I want to write, example. So in order to write this, here we use a code tag. Okay, then E equals to MC square. Code E equals to MC. Here square is it is a normal text, it is a superscript text. So here I am using superscript 2 and close superscript and I am calling the code. So when you execute this, how you will get this? E equals to MC square. Okay, so if you want to create a like mathematical applications, if you want to create any chemical formulas, that is not a normal font, it is a coded text. So if you want to create such type of coded text, we will use a code. Okay, code tag, which is used to display the code. Now, the next one is the address. See, again the tag itself, the tag only you can identify the definition, what is the address. So address, this tag is used to give a complete information about contact means if you want to add any contact information in the web pages. So instead of writing a pre-formatted like that, you can use that the address format, so that it will display as is. Example, GPRDC, example. So this is displayed as it is, and it is if you include inside the address tag, that will be displayed as a contact information. Okay, that is the address. The next one, these are the simple tags. Next one, quote, Q. See, if you want to display any text like this, quotes, A, B, C. Then you include that text between a Q opening and closing. So when you include that text between a Q opening and closing, that text will be displayed as a quote like this. Q, A, B, C, D. Next Q. Okay. This, when you execute this, you will get like this. Okay. So these are the phrase elements, and you have one more phrase element. That is a acronym. Okay, actually, what is the acronym? It is used for an acronym for a text. Example, if you want to give a acronym, then you can write like this. Different tags. What that tags are doing, instead of just displaying a text, that tag itself, they have some meanings. Okay, so these, that is why these are called as a phrase elements. Understood? So here, this is a one important question in your syllabus, and you will get this question in SEO. This practical part I'll show you in the example, and after this I will add the video which contains the practical part of this. As already explained the theory part on the board, that part here I will show you the practical part. Okay, so in order to write that phrase element program, first you open the notepad, because notepad is editor here. Notepad, I am typing notepad. Press enter key. Notepad is displayed. Here you write that code whatever I have explained on the board. HTML, it's the opening tag. Next, head. Inside the head you give the title. What is the title? You can give any title. Here I am giving a phrase element as a title. Close the title. As title is a nested tag, after closing the title only you close the head tag. So here it is a phrase element. Now after closing the title, you close the head section which have opened before the title. I'm giving the head. Now head is closed. So if you want to display any content on the browser window, where that content should be inside the body section. So here I'm giving a body tag, and I'm closing the body. It is better if you close before itself. Next I'm closing HTML. So whatever phrase elements you want to add, that will add slowly one by one. Okay. So first, what phrase element have given? Emphasize. EM. Emphasis it is. Example, GPRDC, or emphasis only I will write. After writing that, close the EM. Now I am saving this file as a phrase. PHRA. Say a phrase dot HTML. So it is HTML. So file extension should be dot HTML. And you give this as a all files. Next, to save it. And the location of this is, you can see here, I am giving the location desktop. Now, save it. Now, I will open that file. Phrase element. Here, you have a phrase element. I am opening with Internet Explorer. this is a Internet Explorer. As I already said, this emphasis is similar to your italic, but it gives more importance, I said. Okay, now come to the next phrase element, strong, which is similar to bold. Again, S-T-R-O-N-G, strong. Strong, S-T-R-O-N-G, strong. Now, after this, again, I'm saving. Go to the browser window. Here, I'm refreshing this. You can see, this is similar to your bold. So, here, I'm not given break tags. So, all the text displaying in a same line. So, in order to display text in the next line, here, I'm adding the break. Save it. Again, come to browser window. Refresh this. Now, this is a strong. Now, next I am giving a next phrase element, ABBR. ABBR. It is a abbreviation, an abbreviation title. Example, I am giving TITLE equals to web technologies. Give in a double quotes, web technologies, and close it. Next, after that, you give the abbreviated word WT, I'm giving in capitals, and close it. After that, you can give in a small ABBR. Now save it. Come to browser window. Refresh this. WT. Now you here you can see the difference. See, when you move your mouse pointer on this abbreviated word, web technology is displaying. Okay, once again I'll show you. See, so this is a abbreviation. Next, one more I'll give you acronym, A-C-R-O-N-Y-M, acronym, acronym, title, T-I-T-L-E, equals to again, web technologies, close this, and example W-T-T I'm writing, and I'm closing acronym. I'm closing the acronym. After that, I'm saving this. Go to browser window, refresh this. See, again you place your mouse pointer on this. Here also it is displaying. So here both are similar, abbreviation and acronym. So here we have different types of phrase elements. We have that phrase elements I'm explaining. Now the next one is a block code, BLO. BLO, CKQUOTE, block quote. And I'm writing text. After that, BLO, CKQUOTE, block quote. Okay, after that, save this. Go to the browser window. Refresh the browser window. You can see. Instead of displaying this from the beginning of the line where it is displaying, from particular position it is displaying, see. So this is called as a section block. Okay, now come to the notepad again. More phrase elements are there. The next one is a Q. Quotes I have explained. A, B, C, D, or we'll give web. Okay, now close this. Q. Save it. Come to browser window, refresh this. Good. So for the web, you are getting double quotes. So if you want to display any text as a quoted text, then we'll include that text between a double quotes. Okay. Now the next phrase element is address. A-D-D-R-E-S-S, address. So example here I'm giving GPRDC. Mehdipatnam,
and I'm closing this. This is your practical question. This is a question from your practical question bank. You can write this in your record also. Save it. Refresh this. See. So it is displaying like address it is displaying. Okay. Now similarly here we have a code. Code. What I have given for code? E equals to MC square. E equals to MC. Square is a superscript. So I am using a SUP. 2. And I am closing this SUP. Save it. And close the code. You can see the difference. See. E equals to MC square. So it is displaying in a code. It is displaying like a code. Here actually it is misplaced. It is after the address. It should be, no? So control X. Come after the address. You include this. Okay. Now save it. Come to browser window. Here you can see E equals to MC square. Okay. This is a code. So when you include any text between a code opening and closing, that will be displayed as a code, like a mathematical expressions, formulas. It will display text like a formulas. Okay. Now here one more is a citation. CIT citation. Example, I am giving ABCD. Next, for that, I am giving ABCD. CIT. By web example. So you can include this in a paragraph actually. Citation. Now close this, save it. See, ABCD by web. Okay, so it will display like a title of the work what you did. Okay, example is as already explained, one subject is teased by so and so, so lecturer. So you can give lecturer name and by. Okay, that you can include between a citation. Okay, next, here the next phrase element is DFN. It stands for the definition. So if you want to create a definition for any particular word, we'll use the DFN tab. So here I'm giving a DFN. Small I'm giving DFN. Example web. Okay, and I'm closing a DFN. After that, I'm giving a definition web technologies. Now close this. Here I am closing as a paragraph. Let's save it. Come to browser window. Refresh this. So web technologies. So it is displaying as a web definitions. But this definition should be included inside a paragraph tag only. So now all of you take a screenshot of this program. Because this is your practical part. Okay, I will font. I am decreasing this. You take a screenshot of this and you write this in your record. So this is about phrase elements. We'll discuss list in the next class. Thank you.